Alright guys, let's get to the point. I purchased this small ZB2 L3 capacity tester to test the capacity of my 18650 lithium ion cells. The most common problem while using these circuits is the two load resistors which gets too hot while discharging the cells. And most of us was using a big heatsink and a cooling fan to decrease the heat of the resistors. But that looks a little bit messy. So I want to make it smaller by using a small heatsink below the circuit and a small cooling fan beside the heatsink which doesn't take much space. So I started cutting a small piece of aluminum sheet and sanded it a little to get a smooth surface. And I already made a few holes on each corner to add some small nut bolts to fix the circuit on it. Then I soldered a couple of wires to the resistor pin of the circuit to connect to the load resistors through the aluminum plate. I connected the both resistors in parallel so it can able to draw 1 amp from the single lithium cell. After adding a thermal paste and connected them together, I used another heatsink which I got from the old computer power supply and it almost the same size of the circuit. And I already made a few holes to connect it below the load resistors by using a couple of zip ties. And these are strong enough to hold them together. Then I used this small 5V cooling fan beside the heatsink to cool down the resistors when they get hot. I connected it in parallel to the load resistor so it will consume the power from the battery when we test the capacity. Then I used the small pieces of acrylic sheets to connect it on top of this board to cover the whole circuit. And I already made a few holes to connect the small caps for the push type buttons to control the circuit and it also gives us a nice pretty look when we fix it. I connected them all together by using a super glue and it dried so quickly. Then I used a normal glue at the bottom because it will be connected on the aluminum plate. I put those small caps in place and connected them together and let it dry for a few hours. And finally, it looks great and now it's time to test it. So I'm using this lithium polymer battery which have 3 cells in parallel used as a low resistors and high current. I powered it by using a small power bank which I was made in my previous video. I set it up to 3 volts and pushed the OK button and it started doing the process. And as you can see, when I pushed the OK button, the small fan started spinning because we are connected it in parallel to the load resistor so that can save a little more power instead of connecting it to the input of the circuit. And after a few minutes of test, the heatsink was totally cool and the load resistors was a little bit warmer and the cooling fan was still spinning even the battery voltage drops to 3.2 volts. That's really perfect. And I hope you guys like this video if you are using this type of capacity testers in your DIY battery projects. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.